What's up, you guys? It's Delise, and I'm an artist, I'm a musician, I'm a singer, songwriter, rapper, I'm a violinist. And today I just wanted to kind of come to you guys and let you guys in on some music that I previously made. Just talk about it a little bit more in detail. So let's get right into it. So the first song that I ever wrote, first video that I ever did, is called For the Mike Browns. This song is just a classic piece, a historical piece, and I'm very, very proud of it. And for those of you that are familiar, even if you're not, I'm just giving you a little background on the piece. So back in like 2014, Michael Brown was 18-year-old from St. Louis, my hometown. He was gunned down by policemen in Ferguson, Missouri. I was in college, you know, 2014, I was in college at Clark Atlanta University, but I came home for the summer, for summer break. I even remember like the day that it happened, I was on Facebook and I remember somebody writing a status about like, yeah, police just gunned down like a teenager in Ferguson. I heard about previous events, you know what I'm saying, like that were similar to this one, like Trayvon Martin, Eric Garner, people that were losing their lives in similar ways and due to police brutality. And so I was definitely affected by that because people were losing their lives. They're really killing our people, like innocent people. They're really killing innocent people over, you know, things that you shouldn't lose your life over. Like, you shouldn't lose your life over Skittles, you know what I'm saying? You shouldn't lose your life over just something that minute. This could be me, this could be my cousin, this could be my sister, a loved one of mine, you know what I'm saying? A close friend, like this, it could be anybody that I love, you know what I'm saying? Anybody that I'm close to. So when this event happened, like in my hometown, it literally hit home. And I don't really think that at the time it dawned on me. I really was kind of in like a state of shock actually, like when this happened. But I really wanted to create a musical piece in honor of these people, to honor their lives, to honor their families, you know what I'm saying? Because they were robbed of their life. They were robbed of some of them, their adulthood, you know what I'm saying? Their children were robbed of, you know, growing up with a parent, you know what I'm saying? So this literally hit home, and I wanted to be a voice for these people. This piece is just really dear to me. So the title For the Mike Browns, it's in no way a generalization of the people that lost their lives before, even after Michael Brown, but it was more so like I said, this really, really hit home. Like, I was aware of previous things that happened, but this actually happened in my neighborhood, so it was like, dang, like Michael Brown died in like a similar way due to police brutality. He died in that same way. So I did this for my city, I did this for Michael Brown, I did this for his family, I did this for people before him, I did this for people after him. And even like when I was doing the video for this song, more people were dying. More and more people were dying due to police brutality. In the video I have people with name tags, people that died due to police brutality. And I had to update the people as we were doing the video. Like, that's just how crazy it was. So this piece is just really a celebration of Michael Brown, a celebration of people before him, people after him. Because like I said, I really wanted to be a voice, and their families were robbed of, you know, love. And that's just not fair. When I was going to record this song, I had like a little outro left in the song. And I was like, man, what do I want to put right there? I had like a spoken part that I was going to put, but it just wasn't fitting right for me. I kind of put myself in the shoes of Michael Brown and like the people that were on the other side of the gun. I wanted to like voice kind of like what they may have been feeling. So I'm gonna just kind of sing the part for you. This is like probably my favorite part of the song. I love the entire thing, but this one really is my favorite part. So it goes like this. It's just me and the gun, and it feels like I'm done for. Trying to find a way, do I accept death or run for my life, my life, my life? Oh, I don't know. Where do I go from here? Where do I go from here? But I know a change gon' come. Yeah. So yeah, if you haven't checked that out already, check out For the Mike Browns. It's a classic piece, it's a historical piece. And I'm just glad that I could be a part of history. You know, I actually experienced this. Like, I actually experienced the process, you know. And just the fact that this happened in my hometown, it's crazy. Like, I still can't even grasp that. Like, I was there, you know what I'm saying? But more importantly, this song is for Michael Brown. This song is for the people like Trayvon Martin, all the people that lost their lives due to police brutality, because this is still going on today. People are still talking about this. It's still happening, you know, in live time, you know what I'm saying? In present time, this is still happening. So I'm just happy that I could write this piece, you know, in honor of those people, in honor of their lives, and just for their families. So the next song we're going to get into is called Sauce Together. I was on some cocky shit. I was on my cocky shit. Sometimes you just...
I mean, I guess she's kind of cute.
You know what I'm saying? You just got to let a bitch know. I had, like, a great idea to do two characters, so I wanted to play two characters. Kind of like on some Nutty Professor type of stuff. So I was playing Science Me, and I was playing, like, regular, like, everyday glamorous me. So the Science Me was following glamorous me all throughout the video to collect her data, because she wanted to get the sauce. She needed, you know, to collect her data to get the sauce. You know, she wanted to be cool like glamorous me. You know what I'm saying? So throughout the video, she's collecting her data, she's spying on glamorous me, and by the end of the video, she goes to her lab, cooks something up, but she ain't got the sauce, she ain't got the juice. So she cooks something up, but the experiment blow up in her face. She just ain't got the sauce. So the experiment failed, you know, but that was just like a really cool video for me to do. I wanted to just have some fun, talk my shit, you know. And I had a great time doing that. I think the video turned out amazing, so I'm proud of that piece too. I'm proud of the song. And yeah, check that out. Sauce Together. Next video, Misbehaving. So, okay, it's so funny. This was actually for my 25th birthday. Every birthday, every year for my birthday, I always want to do something that's, like, super cool, kind of, like, out of the box, you know? So, for my 25th birthday, that's, like, a milestone birthday. So, I was like, dang, I kind of want to do something a little different for my birthday this year. I think I want to do a music video. So, I actually remixed Juvenile's song, Back That Ass Up, and talked about me turning 25. It was all about me being 25. So yeah, we turned up, you know, we had cake for the video, we had drink for the video, we had silly string. We was lit, we turned up, you know, I can't even play. I had fun shooting this video, and I think it turned out amazing. Also, since the title of the song, I originally was naming it Misbehaving, like the word misbehaving. So the behind the scenes, my videographer, he was doing like a behind the scenes video for me. He thought that the title was Misbehaving, like M-I-S-S and then behaving. And I was like, man, that is cool. I'm stealing that. So that's how we came up with the title Misbehaving for this video. So shout out to my videographer, he's the shit. Follow him on YouTube too, William Media's. Next video, next song, Heaven Sent. This is my most recent project, my most recent music video. I'm so proud of this piece because it just means so much to me. In this song, you can really get to know me. This is the least, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's not like a definition of me. This is how she grew up. She grinding. I think through this song, people can really get to know me a little bit better. And that's something that I really like about the song. The idea behind this song actually came from Kodak Black. Shout out to him. He's like probably one of my favorite like rappers. I love his voice on the track. I love his flow. Say what you want to about Kodak, but I love me some Kodak Black. I love his flow. He be like right in pocket every time. His song Testimony though, he talks about, you know, his life, life experiences, and I could listen to that song all day. Because it's just so raw. I really wanted to come up with something like similar, you know, the beat is catchy. And so for Heaven Sent, I talk about my life, things that I've been through. You know, I'm just coming up as an artist. So that's why this piece is so like dear to me. Like, shout out to my videographer, William Media. He shot the video to this. I'm telling you, when he showed me, the first time I saw this video, I was like, oh my God, this is like exactly what I was going for, plus some. I just didn't expect him to really like act up on that video. He did his thing, I can't even lie. So if you haven't seen Heaven Sent, check that out. Subscribe to my channel, like my videos. You know, if you like my videos, give me a thumbs up while I'm done. Follow me on Instagram at the least. You can see my drip today, but if you follow me on the gram, you will be able to. But yeah, follow me. If you got some DMs, send them my way. I'm up, link my email and all that. But well, if you want to do some collabs, shoot, just hit me up. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.
Peace out.